Well, he created a Halloween hell like no other.
Yes, but 4 years ago tonight, police caught up with Peter Braunstein. He had sexually abused and terrorized a woman and filled the city with fear. In a CBS 2 exclusive, Mary Calvey, here's the confessions of a madman.
In the fall of 2005, a young woman opened her door to terror. The attacker posed as a New York City firefighter and sexually tormented his victim for 13 hours.
People have called you a madman.
Yeah, I know. I wouldn't contest that.
Today, Peter Braunstein serves his 18 years to life sentence in a maximum security prison at Denimora near the Canadian border. Prison guards warned our news crew he could attack again and asked that we keep our distance.
Why did you commit this crime?
I think I wanted to do something as a final gesture. I had this thing about originality. I didn't really want to do what someone else had already done.
The fired fashion writer targeted a former coworker.
She seemed to represent in a kind of abstract way all the issues that I had with the fashion industry. I bought all the equipment off of eBay, and it took a while, you know, because you have to bid and do that whole bidding thing.
Then he tracked her down.
Through the internet.
Through the internet.
That's how I found out where she lived. I set off so many smoke bombs I could barely see. I subdued her, I chloroformed her to knock her out.
What he did next was hold her captive, tormenting her and sexually abusing her. At trial, she testified she didn't know whether she would live or die.
What would you say to your victim today?
What would I say to her now? I should have chosen someone else.
Is there any remorse?
I regret the victim, but not the crime.
On that day of terror, Braunstein left his victim tied up and simply walked out of her apartment. For 6 weeks, no one knew where he was. And now, for the first time, we're learning what happened.
It was like part road trip, part crime spree. I actually had an itinerary. I went to Cleveland to see the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Then I always wanted to see Graceland because I'm like kind of an Elvis fan. By this time it was really heated up.
Before it was over, Peter Braunstein added a few petty crimes along the way. He was finally stopped in Memphis, Tennessee. He admits if he hadn't been caught, his rampage would have included a killing spree in New York.
I was trying to do this and then get back to New York. Settle the score with a few people. It involved trying to, you know, take out as many people as I could in a... Like kill, you know, like, but in a targeted way, you know, not in a Columbine kind of way.
As we all know, that attempt failed. More than 4 years now in prison. Has anything changed?
It's possible to accomplish things while you're in jail. You can bedevil people in the outside world, like haunt them and torment them.
The focus of his rage, he says, was an ex-girlfriend who he claims drove him insane. He never went after her, instead focusing on a woman they worked with in the same fashion magazine office, a secondary vendetta, he called it. Mary Calvey, CBS 2 News.
Peter Braunstein now says that his defense was flawed, but it is highly unlikely the legal outcome will ever change. Also, his chance at parole is highly unlikely.